Hello everybody and welcome to German class. In today's lecture we are going to talk about our another case, dative case, right? So we are going to talk about dative case. It's very important. We have talked about nominative case, we have talked about our accusative case. So this is our next case, which is known as dative. So we will be revising in this lecture, we will be revising first nominative, then we will be revising accusative, and then we will be thoroughly discussing about the dative case. It's very important. Mainly we will be focusing on dative verbs, right? So first of all, what do you understand by the word dative? Dative. So in German, if I talk about subject, subject is known as nominative. Now verb is verb only, verben, we say verben, so verbs, right? But if I talk about object, if I talk about object, it can be accusative or it can be dative. So if I talk about object, it can be accusative and it can be dative. So you know, if it is a direct object, if it is a direct object, it is accusative. If it is an indirect object, it is dative. So what is dative? Dative is an object only, but what kind of object? It is an indirect object, it is not a direct object. So what is accusative? Accusative is also an object, but what kind of object? It is an direct object, right? So next is, when do we use dative? Like first, like, okay, dative is indirect object, but but what are the conditions to use dative? First is when we have some specific verbs which are known as dative verbs, which are known as dative verbs. So first is after dative verbs we use dative. Second is after dative prepositions we use dative. Third is with some adjectives. So dative adjectives, we have, you know, so there are some particular sentences with some adjectives where we use dative, like mehr ist langweilig or mehr ist heiß. So that we will discuss later on. This also we will discuss later on. In today's lecture, we are going to focus on dative verbs only. So, you know, dative verbs, when do we use dative? We use dative after dative verbs. So what are dative verbs? So in today's lecture we are going to talk about only this part. So you know, if I talk about subject, what is subject? It is nominative. Verb remains verb, and then object, if it is an indirect object, it will be dative. If it is a direct object, it will be accusative, right? So this thing should be very clear to you. Now if I talk about when do we use dative, it will come after some dative verbs. After dative verbs, please add dative verbs. After dative verbs, so dative verbs, there are some verbs which are known as pure dative verbs, and there are some verbs which are known as mixed verbs. Like these verbs can take accusative and as well as dative, and these verbs will take only dative, and these verbs will not take accusative. So these verbs will take only dative and not accusative, hence these are pure dative verbs. These are mixed verbs. This can take accusative and dative, but in today's lecture we will be discussing only pure dative verbs. We will not be discussing about the mixed verbs. We will be discussing about pure dative verbs. Like first verb I have taken here is helfen. Helfen means to help. Now it is a pure dative verb, so whatever is coming after helfen will be dative. Like here, the man helps the lady. Now what is subject? Subject means who. Who is helping? So the man is helping. This is subject. This is subject. This is verb. And this is an object. Now, if the verb is pure dative verb, then whatever is coming after the, then whatever is coming as an object will be treated as dative. Whatever is coming as an object will be treated as dative. So here the object is the lady, and this verb help belongs to pure dative verb. So I will give you some verbs which belong to pure dative verbs, right? There are some specific some near about 20 verbs which fall under the category of pure dative verbs. This is one of the examples, helfen. Now whatever is coming as an object will be treated as dative. Hence der Mann hilft der Frau. So der is dative here. That I'll discuss when we will talk about articles. But for the time being, you just understand that this thing is dative, this thing is verb, and this thing is nominative. Only this much thing you need to understand. Now let's see this. It says another example, helfen, again dative verb, like do you help the child. Now what is verb here? Help. This is verb. What is subject? You is subject. What is the child? The child is an object. Now what kind of object is it? Like subject is nominative, verb is verb, but this is dative. Why dative? The reason is verb. If the verb belongs to pure dative verbs, so whatever is coming as an object will be treated as dative. So hence this hilft is verb, do is nominative, and dem Kind is dative. Now why I have written hilft? Because do ending should be st. Hence hilft. This we have done in our initial classes with verb conjugation. And then dem Kind, this dem I have written as dative article. This dem, why dative? Why dem? This we will be covering in our article class. But for the timing, you just need to understand that this is dative. Okay, the next verb is gehören. Gehören is, which means to belong. To belong. Now this is again a pure dative verb. Now if I read the sentence here, it says the pen belongs to me. Like this is subject, this is verb, and this is an object. So what is subject? Subject is nominative, verb is verb, and if the verb belongs to pure dative verb, the object will be dative, right? So in this sentence, der Kuli gehört mir. What do you need to focus for the time being? This is nominative, this is verb, but pure dative verb, and this is an object, but what kind of object? It is a dative object. Similarly here, next verb is antworten. Antworten is to answer, and it will always take a dative object, right? So if the sentence is he answers the teacher, so what is he? He is nominative, subject, answers is verb, but it is a pure dative verb. So whatever is coming as an object will be treated as dative object. So for the timing, you just need to understand that er is nominative, antwortet is dative verb, and dem Lehrer is a dative object. And why I have written dem here? Because article that we'll be discussing in article topic in our upcoming lessons, right? So dem article, and why dem? This we will discuss later on, but for the timing you just need to focus on that this is dative. Okay, next verb is danken. Like here, I thank you. So I is nominative, subject, thank is verb, and you is an object. So ish danke dear. Ish is subject, nominative, danke verb, and dear is dative. Now you know this is a pure dative verb, and why I have written dear, this we'll be discussing when we'll be discussing personal pronouns. So I have not written do, I have not written dish, I have written dear. The reason is do is nominative, dish is accusative, and dear is dative. But this topic we'll be discussing in detail when we'll be discussing personal pronouns. But for the time being, we are discussing verbs only. Verbs. We are focusing on verbs. So you just need to focus on verb, right? Similarly here, gratulieren. Gratulieren is to congratulate. To congratulate. You need to focus on verb. Like, I congratulate the child on birthday. So I is subject. Congratulate is verb. The child is an object on birthday. So that is preposition plus object. So ish is nominative. Gratuliere is verb. Dem Kind, the child, is dative. And zum Geburtstag is remaining part of the sentence. Okay. Here are a few more examples, like zuhören. Zuhören is to listen carefully. So it says die Schüler, the school students, hören dem Professor zu. Now zuhören is a separable verb. If you remember the separable verb, the prefix this zu will go at the end of the sentence. Hence I have written zu here. And hören will come at first, so that is why hören I have written here. So if you have not revised separable verbs, please revise separable verbs, right? Separable verb can also belong to dative verbs. So zuhören. So the students is subject, verb is zuhören, and dem Professor is object, but which object? Dative object. Similarly here, schmecken. Schmecken is to taste. So das Essen schmeckt mir sehr gut. So das Essen is nominative, schmeckt is verb, mir is dative, and sehr gut is remaining part of the sentence. And here, glauben. Glauben is to believe. Right, to believe. So dear student glaubt ihr nicht, the student does not believe her. So dear student is nominative, glaubt is verb, ihr is object but dative object, and nicht is a remaining part of the sentence. Similarly here, absagen. Now absagen is a separable verb. Absagen is to cancel. Now it says ich muss dir für morgen absagen. I must cancel the plan for tomorrow. Now muss is a modal verb, and for modal verb the rule says that the second verb will go at the end of the sentence in its infinitive form. So if you have not revised modal verbs, please revise modal verbs also, because modal verb rule says that, you know, the second verb will go at the end of the sentence and it will come as it is. So I have written as it is, although it is a separable verb, but I have not written sagen ab. I have written ab sagen. The reason is modal verb is there. So ish is nominative. There are two verbs. One is modal verb, another is infinitive. And here dear is a dative, and für morgen is remaining part of the sentence. Now what you are supposed to do, you need to find out the meaning of these verbs. So all these verbs are pure dative verbs, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Although there are 8 to 10 more verbs are there which belongs to pure dative verbs, but for the time being, post your answers in the chat box. What are the meanings? Find out the meanings from the dictionary. What are the meanings of these 12 verbs? And then post your answers in the chat box. Okay, so if you have posted your answers in the chat box, then check your answers. Absagen is to cancel. Antworten is to reply. Danken is to thank. Fehlen is to miss. Gefallen is to like. Gehören, to belong. Glauben, to believe. Gratulieren, to congratulate. Helfen, to help. Passieren, to happen. Raten, to advise. Schmecken, to taste. So here are the meaning. Check your meaning. And if you have any doubt, please ask. So thank you so very much. Viel Spaß. Have fun. Danke. Thank you. So I hope you must have learned some dative verbs. What are dative verbs? So there are two verbs. One are pure dative verbs. This is what we have covered up today. And some are also mixed verbs, which we will be covering up very soon. Right. So that is all for today. Thank you. Take care of yourself, everybody. And be safe.